deal with all that up in there.
Please get your name and all that out of the way, please.
Can we cut that, please, on the church of the new conference right now, please?
Good morning. I'm Sergeant Joseph Catastani with the LAPD Topanga Division. Yesterday, Dallas PD notified LAPD that one of Texas's ten most dangerous fugitives was possibly in the Topanga area. LAPD officers were able to locate a possible suspect, and a pursuit ensued. The vehicle crashed in the area of Sarania Avenue and Wells Drive, and two suspects fled on foot. After a short canine search, two suspects were taken into custody, and no outstanding suspects are at large at this point.
Can you tell us about the original suspect, Christopher Gonzalez, who was tipped off by Topanga PD? How exactly were you told he was in this area? Was he a geotag?
That, I have no idea as far as the information, as far as how they located him. We were just told by Dallas PD that he was possibly in the area, in the area of Canoga, and I believe.
Was he bitten by police officers before he was transported to a Kaiser Wilhelm?
I don't have any information.
What happens now? Is he going to be extradited to Dallas?
More than likely, yes.
What about the second suspect?
He's going to be, at this point, he's being detained for the pursuit.
Is he someone who is wanted as well?
I don't have that information. I believe it was the fugitive from Dallas.
Did canines play a role?
The canine units did locate the suspect, and they were taken into custody.
Can you say the name of the fugitive out of Dallas?
At this point, I don't have that information.
I'm hoping you can answer this question. Just as an officer approaching the situation when it involves another jurisdiction, and you don't have a history of this person and know what he's involved with, how do you, your officers tackle that? How do you approach it?
Well, we had very limited information other than that he was one of the 10 most wanted out of Dallas. But again, we tried to obtain that information by contacting that agency and going from there.
Tell us about the pursuit, how long it, where it started, how long it lasted.
It was a short pursuit, started in the area of Canoga and Woodland, and ended, like I said, in the distance of Sarania Avenue and Wells Drive. It's probably approximately less than 2 miles.
You said last night, so I mean, you said yesterday. Was this like last night in Dallas contact?
It was yesterday during daylight hours. I don't know.
But you didn't find them until what time?
That I can't remember. Approximately, it was after midnight.
Oh, okay.
Can you spell?
I don't have that information.
You said the fugitive from Dallas was driving the car?
I don't have that information.
Can you spell
the fact that they fled the vehicle and the danger to the community, what this did to the community for those at least for an hour or 2 hours when these suspects were in the area?
Well, luckily it happened very early in the morning, so the general public that was possibly having to get up in the morning for work was not, did not affect them.
You got no weapons located?
I don't have any.
The vehicle was the one that was driving and wasn't transported to Texas.
I don't have that information.
There was no vehicle in the crash area in Sarania. Do you know what he was doing in this
Could you spell your last name?
My last name is spelled Cavastani, or pronounced Cavastani, spelled C-A-V-E-S-T-A-N-Y. All right, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Joseph.